Hello, and welcome back to Angular 2 Essential Training. In this section, we'll be discussing HTTP and observables. HTTP is what we use whenever we want to retrieve something from a database or an API. Not a lot has changed between Angular 1 and Angular 2 in this regard. We're still using the keyword HTTP in order to perform our requests. What has changed is how we handle the response. Angular 2 has made the switch to using RxJS observables. Observables essentially emit responses over time instead of the response being a one-time occurrence. So we'll first discuss what an observable is and how it differs from a typical promise-based response. Then we'll discuss how to perform HTTP requests. This will include performing an HTTP GET request to retrieve our data, processing the response object using an observable, and then subscribing to the observable in our component. We'll be using our ng on init lifecycle hook in order to display our data. In this video, we'll dig deep into understanding observables. Observables are part of the Reactive Extensions Library, also known as RxJS, and they are used extensively in Angular 2. You can learn all about ReactiveX here at reactivex.io. Now, the purpose of ReactiveX is to provide an API for asynchronous programming with observable streams. So what does that mean exactly? It means that observables provide us with an asynchronous stream of data that we can subscribe to, so that when new data has been emitted, we can automatically receive the new data coming in. You can think of this as receiving the changes in stock prices. Since the price of stocks is constantly fluctuating, an observable could be used to update these prices as they come in. Observables work like an array, so we'll be using the map operator in order to process the response. To better understand this, let's go over to the reactivex.io and then click Choose Your Platform and then JavaScript. So we get taken to this GitHub page. If we scroll down a bit, we can see an example. This is very similar to what our service will look like. So this source is going to be the response we get back, like a JSON file, for example. Then we can filter the response to match a selected criteria. Then we need to call map on the response in order to shape the data. Once the data is shaped, it gets passed to the subscriber. This subscriber is going to be located inside of our component, and it's going to be used to display the data in our view and process any errors. So how is an observable different from a promise? Observables work with multiple values over time, whereas promises return only a single value. Observables are cancelable. Promises are not cancelable. Observables can be manipulated using JavaScript functions like map, filter, and reduce. So now that we have a better understanding of what observables are, let's discuss working with HTTP requests. We use HTTP in order to send requests for data. A few requests we can make are GET requests in order to fetch some data, and PUT requests that are used to add or alter some piece of data. Angular makes it very easy for us to work with these HTTP requests. All we need to do is import HTTP from angular/HTTP, and then add the HTTP module inside of our ng module file and add it to our list of imports. We need to create an instance of HTTP so it can be used in our class. We do this inside of the constructor by adding a private variable of HTTP. Then we can make requests. In this case, it's a GET request made to books.json file located in our API folder. And then we need to map a response before sending it to the component. Let's now add an HTTP GET request to our application. Here we are back in our application. Let's open up the book service file. Here you can see we've hard-coded in some books. What we want to do is instead grab all of the books located in our books.json file here. Quick note, please make sure to download the separate books.json file located in the resources folder of this lecture and then add it in here. So the first thing we'll do is import HTTP from angular/HTTP. Next, we'll open up the app.module file and import HTTP module, and then add it to our list of imports. I'll make sure to import Observable from RxJS as well. Now the first thing I'll do is inside of the constructor, we'll include a private variable of _HTTP assigned to the HTTP instance. I'll then change this iBook declaration to be an observable array of type iBook, and then remove the hard-coded data. And then I can say return this _HTTP referencing our variable, and then .get and pass in the location of our file in relation to our index.html file, so it's located at api/books/books.json. Then we need to format the data a little before giving it to the component. To do so, we'll use the map operator. So we'll say .map, and here we need to actually import map from RxJS in order to use this method. So we'll add an import statement for the method above, and then down below, we pass in a parameter representing the data. So we'll say response. Now we ask the question, what is the type of this response? And since we're getting back more than just the data, for example, we're also getting back header information along with the status, we should use Angular's built-in response interface. And this is located in the same folder as HTTP. So then we take a response, make sure it's turned into JSON, and is of type iBook. So this is all that we need to do in order to retrieve the data and pass it along to the component. We'll be adding some error handling in the next lecture, but for now, let's just see how to display this data in our component. So opening up our books list component file, I'll first remove our call to get books from the constructor. Now I want the data to appear as the page is loaded. The convention is to put service-related logic inside of the ng-onInit lifecycle hook. So we'll first add our onInit after component, then say books list component implements onInit, and add our ng-onInit hook after the constructor. I'm going to add inside of these curlies a method to get books that will be defined below. Then we'll create our method called getBooks. This method will then call the getBooks method on BookService to retrieve all of the books from our JSON file. If all of these getBooks are confusing, you can name this something different, like getAllBooks. But I'm just going to leave it as getBooks for now. And the last step is that we need to subscribe to the observable using .subscribe. Then passing in a parameter that represents the data that we get back. This name here can be anything you want, but in this case, we'll say books, then arrow function, this.books equals books. So this might look a little weird also, but all we're doing is we're taking the response and then setting it equal to our books property right here. This would work the same if we changed books to something like response. Lastly, we need to add another parameter to subscribe in case that there is an error. So we'll say error, then arrow function, this.errorMessage equals an error of type any, and then set up a property of errorMessage to type string. Now let's load up our app and see the results so far. So we're now looping through each one of the books in our API, and that's great. But it does look pretty broke. There's two things that we need to do in order to fix this. First, we need to change the properties in our iBook interface to reflect that of our API. So you can copy this over or just download the file. And second, we need to edit our books list HTML file to reflect the properties of our API. So see if you can make these correct changes here yourself. And the answer is going to be in the next lecture. Hey guys, welcome back. In this video, we're going to fix our listings. So if you haven't tried to fix this yourself, I recommend you give it a shot. Then once that's done, we're going to add some error handling to our service and explore a few of the RxJS operators. So right now, our app is broke since we've added the service to our component, but we haven't adjusted the HTML. So let's do that now. The first thing I'll do is get rid of these other columns that contain the hard-coded data. I'm going to keep this favorite message div. We're still iterating over books and books, so I'll leave that as well. But I am going to get rid of these two buttons that we won't be using anymore. So let's open up our books.json file so we can get a reference to our items. The image of our books is right here as image URL, so we'll change that. Instead of book price, it's just named price. Book title is called name. Book author is just author. Book description is simply description. Published on is now called release date. We're still using book.instock, but I've changed this to be a Boolean in the JSON file. We can use something similar to the hide image logic above. So I'll just copy that over and say that if the book is in stock, meaning if it's set to true, display the string yes, otherwise no. Then instead of book reviews, we'll say star rating. And then I'm going to get rid of this books in stock p element. And then fix this BS favorite area to say book.starRating and book.name. Now let's save everything and see the results. Okay, looks pretty good. Let's now add some error handling to our service. Right now, we're just sending back the data from our API endpoint, but not doing anything in the event the file isn't found or something misfires. So I'll open up my book service file and first create a private error handling method named handleError. I'll create a variable here named message that's going to display our error message. And then I can return the observable, attaching to it the throw method, passing in our message. We're using a new RxJS operator here called throw, so we need to import it. Instead of listing these operators individually, we could import the entire RxJS library like this, but this is actually not recommended since RxJS is a big library and we don't need everything in there. Now let's edit our getBooks method to include the error handling below. We can first chain the method do, which will allow us to log a message after the data has been received. And then also add the catch method passing in this.handleError in the event an error is received. And we'll make sure to import these two new operators up above. And then let's just break our API call by adding an extra S to the end of our endpoint. And now on refresh, we get a nice descriptive error message alerting us of the problem with the response object.